one of my goals with an audiobook is to make it sound to the listener like I'm sitting right next to them.
I'm Jeb Blount. I'm the author of 10 books, including Fanatical Prospecting, Sales EQ, Objections. And we're here in the audiobook studio called Listen Up Studios here in East Atlanta. And we're recording my brand new book, Fanatical Military Recruiting. Recording an audiobook is a grueling process. It's hours and hours and hours of sitting in a chair, reading off of an iPad. And it's the reason I have these reading glasses is because it starts to strain your eyes. When I say hours and hours, the book that we're recording right now, Fanatical Military Recruiting, probably gonna be 24 to 27 hours of sitting in a chair and reading the book. And the reason it takes so long is that you have to stop, you get things wrong, you read things the wrong way. Because I'm the author, sometimes I decide to change a passage in the book because it sounds a little bit better in spoken word than it does in written word. And fortunately, I have a producer that'll stop me sometimes and say, well, you garbled that or you said this. It's an investment of time and effort and love and emotion to build a great audio book, but it's not one of my favorite things to do. This is what it looks like sitting in the booth. There's a microphone overhead. I've got an iPad right here in front of me that has the book on it. I've kind of got to blow that up. You can see that I've got these reading glasses on just because my eyes get so strained looking at it. And of course, I've got a giant cup of coffee because when you sit in the seat for 8 to 9 hours at a time, you need something to keep you fueled up. It takes between 20 and 30 hours of studio time to record an audiobook, and that translates into roughly 6 to 8 hours of spoken word when you download the book on Audible or Google Play or iTunes. If you listen to audiobooks, you know that most authors don't read their books. Most authors are not willing to go through this process of sitting in a studio for 24 hours reading their book, so the publisher or the author gets an actor to sit in for them who reads the book. And I can notice the difference when the author is reading the book and when the author is not reading the book. And the books that I love the most are when the author is reading the book because you can hear the author's passion in the words. And they know where to put the right inflection. They know what to say. And they know how to keep me engaged. And sometimes I find myself drifting off where an actor's reading the book and it's just sort of a droning on and a droning on. So that's why I put the extra effort in to read my books, because I think it's the right thing to do for the audience.
My name is Dante Hodge. I'm an engineer here at beautiful Listen Up Audiobooks in beautiful East Atlanta Village. The key to producing a great audiobook is learning who you're working with. You know, you have to know the talent and know what they're trying to accomplish. So for example, working with Jeb, I know that he wants his listeners to feel like he's talking directly to them. He wants to make it very personal. So I know I have to allow him that room to make it personal while also adding my input to make sure that we get it the right way.
Doing an audiobook is really, really hard for a guy like me, who's never sit still, always moving, always going. Part of what I do with audiobooks is I do change the words around. Yeah. I change it so it's more conversational. Right. A lot of times we get comments online, people say, well, it's like you're sitting right next to me.
Right.
In fact, it was funny, I called somebody the day ago, called me, and they answer their phone, and they're like, oh my God, you're on my radio. You know, you're on I'm playing you over my speakers right now.
Yeah.
Because people feel like, you know, you're sitting right next to them talking. So sometimes you got to change things around. One of my goals with an audiobook is to make it sound to the listener like I'm sitting right next to them. I mean, think about most of the people that are listening to my audiobooks. They're sales professionals and sales leaders who are in their cars, going on sales calls, going to work, getting ready for the day, getting fired up. And a lot of listeners listen to my book over and over and over again. So my goal is to be a companion, to make it as if I'm their coach as they go out on their sales day or they come back from a sales call, and to provide information in the book that can help them make the next call better or help them earn the deal that they're trying to close, and ultimately to help them build their income and grow their career.